Buganda Road Court Gordon Magistrate Jali Abasajja Balaba yesterday released 18 anti-graft protesters who were arrested on 23rd July as they marched towards Parliament demanding the resignation of the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among. The suspects were released on cash and non-cash bail of 200,000 shillings. The suspects were ordered to return to the same court on September 5th. Some of them are students in tertiary institutions. They have been charged with offences of being a common nuisance and idle and disorderly.
Court fails to concur with the submission of the counsel for the imposed person and adds that the submission of the prosecution was speculative in nature, not substantiated with any law and evidence, and they are overruled. The accused person should be brought to court on the 5th day of September 2024 at 9:00 hearing. The bail of inmate Barazikeza has been extended to that.
They, however, denied the charges. The irresistible beat of kadodi drums is an attraction of many of the young and old who engage in the dance. Accompanied by the intoxication of various alcoholic beverages at the site, the revelers, dominated by youth, dance themselves to vulnerability. Here, cases of sexual abuse due to the set environment take root, leading to unwanted pregnancies and sexually transmitted diseases. During this year's event, Hope Mbale, a local NGO, launched a week-long campaign to keep in check the sexual reproductive health of young people as they practice their culture. Leah Nadunga is the project coordinator.
We are trying to give the accurate information on sexual reproductive health to our young people, because you realize that during the festival season, there are many cultural practices being practiced in this place, which can lead our young people into danger.
Among the critical services offered during this campaign include providing free treatment and counseling to youth, offering psychosocial support, and promoting moral behavior during the imbalo season. There is, however, a challenge faced by this project, as many youth decline to visit and take up the free sexual reproductive services at the site.
Some of them feel like they are being forced to take HIV tests that they don't feel ready to take. Others feel like the information that they are going to get is not really important to them.
The Imbalo launch ceremony that attracts mammoth crowds is set for Saturday this week at Mototo Culture Grounds in the Industrial Division of Mbale City. Initiatives such as reproductive health campaigns using peer-to-peer methods are a key strategy in efforts to safeguard youth at Mototo Culture Grounds come Saturday. Relentless downpours and howling winds hampered Wednesday's search for survivors of landslides that struck Indian tea plantations and killed at least 150 people, most believed to be laborers and their families. Days of torrential monsoon rains have battered the southern coastal state of Kerala, with blockade roads into the Wayanad district disaster area complicating relief efforts. With the only bridge connecting the worst hit villages that was swept away, rescue teams were forced to carry bodies on stretchers out of the disaster zone using a makeshift zipline erected over raging floodwaters. Several who managed to flee the initial impact of the landslides found themselves caught in a nearby river that had burst its banks. Volunteer rescue Arun Dev told AFP at a hospital treating survivors. Wayanad is framed for the tea estates that crisscross its hilly countryside, which rely on a large pool of laborers for planting and harvest. A number of brick-walled row homes built to accommodate seasonal workers were also washed away. Other buildings were caked with mud, and the force of the landslide scattered cars.